Hi, welcome to the City Insider. I'm Melissa Ryerson. We have an exciting show for you today. It's all about the events that happen right here in the city of Franklin. We have dozens of events every year, and it brings thousands of people to our lovely city. Now, the events process starts right here in City Hall, and the first stop is right here in the Administration Building. Let's go talk to Monique McCullough, who makes it all happen. We're here in Monique McCullough's office, and she's been with the city for 9 years and working on special events in our city. This is the first stop if people want an event in our city, and people really need to plan ahead of time. Talk about the process.
They certainly do. We require that applications are turned in 90 days in advance, but we like at least a 180-day notice, just because the process takes so long. The event applications are available on our website or either here in City Hall, and applicants can come and pick them up at any time.
Now, this is really a process because the application is reviewed by someone in almost every city department, mm-hmm. right? How does that work?
Actually, every city department has a member on our special events committee. They review the applications first, and after they've reviewed them, the applicant comes in and meets with that committee. And we talk about the event, the logistics, any conditions or recommendations that our department is going to make, we discuss at that event meeting with the applicant. So they understand where the city is coming from, and we understand exactly what the applicant is requesting. And after that, the applicant has to go before the Board of Mayor and Aldermen, where they'll discuss those conditions and recommendations and either approve or deny the event.
Oftentimes you'll have an applicant come in and say, well, I'm just going to have a 5K run. All I need is the streets closed off and I don't need any help. But really there are other departments involved in something like that. Kind of talk about that.
There is. You know, you wouldn't think the solid waste would be needed in just a street closure, but they are, because we certainly expect our streets to be cleaned up before the event just as much as they are after the event. So every department is involved in every event that we have here at the city.
So there's a lot of planning beforehand to make sure that these events go as smoothly as they do, and they usually do go really smoothly. What are some of the regular events we have in our city?
We have 8 main events that we have here in downtown Franklin. Fela Franklin event, which is in March, our Main Street Festival, which has been going on for years, Franklin on the 4th, the Jazz Festival, Wind Down Main Street, Pumpkin Fest, and Dickens Over Christmas.
Well, those are the big events, but there's also a lot of events that happen throughout the year. How many of those do we have, or what do you estimate each year that we have in Franklin?
Gosh, I would estimate maybe 30 events this year, from a small little 5K run that maybe only 100 people participate to the Main Street Festival, where we have tens of thousands of people visit our city.
Now, there's a lot of planning that goes into before the event, but organizers really need to think of the event from the beginning to the end, because at the event, everyone kind of wants to go home. Mm-hmm. Talk a little bit about that.
They do, and you know, our city staff is the same way. After, you know, work day is over, we like to leave, but there are certain things that need to be done after the event in terms of cleanup or getting the streets back open, making sure our police are taking care of the public safety aspect of the event. So we like our event applicants to stay throughout the event until the streets are reopened.
All right, well, you're going to be seeing a little bit more of Monique a little bit later in the program. Right now, we're going to go to Charles Warner, and he's going to give you the side from the police perspective and how they help with the events. Charlie?
That's right, Melissa, and we're outside of City Hall on 3rd Avenue, where a lot of our events happen right here downtown. With me to talk a little bit about the police department's involvement and role in those events, not only the planning, but actual execution of those events, is Sergeant David Prather. Good morning, Sergeant Prather.
Good morning, Sergeant Warner.
Hey, tell us a little bit about the traffic unit's role in not only the planning, but also the execution of the traffic plan to make sure that everything is routed safely, people get to where they need to go, while keeping and protecting the people that are at the events safe.
Right. What we do is weeks out, we meet with other department heads to coordinate this, especially the street department, and they supply the barricades for us. And what we'll do before the event takes place and the street closure is getting ready to happen, we'll send officers out to go ahead and put the barricades in place. And then we'll stand by the barricades to make sure that we don't have people moving the barricades or trying to go around them.
Traffic around these events seem to get smoother and smoother with every single one, and that probably comes from a little bit of experience planning and coordination with other departments within the city.
That's absolutely right. Like I said, we work with the street department and other members within the city to make sure that these closures go smoothly.
Thank you, Sergeant Prather. On her segue this morning with us is Officer Rose Stegall, the department's community relations officer. Officer Stegall is also heavily involved in the planning of each of these events, not only beforehand, but actually while the event is unfolding, coordinating volunteers, coordinating patrol during the event, explorers, things like that. Officer Stigall, tell us a little bit about what you do for the planning and the operation of these events.
Well, similar to Sergeant Prather and what he just alluded to, we do get with all the other departmental heads. We have a special meeting. I also call the coordinator of that particular event, set up any safety issues, also coordinate with him how many officers might be required in order to safely operate and make sure that there's enough officers for security. I do secure enough volunteers that would be Franklin Police volunteers, and there might be some explorers. The day of the event, we're bright and early, maybe an hour before, making sure that all the barricades are where they need to be, and that we just carry out the event and make sure that everything is coordinated appropriately.
And tell us a little bit about the volunteers and the explorers that are used during these events. A lot of people might not realize that the people that they see walking around in a jacket that says Franklin Police Volunteer or Police Explorer, they may not understand fully what they do. These are people that are donating their time 100% to make our events safer by partnering with the police department and the city of Franklin. Is that right?
That is true, Sergeant Warner. Franklin Police Volunteer, right now we have about eight, and they're in a specialized uniform. It does say Franklin Police Volunteer. They have a little vest on, and they monitor the barricades, making sure that the barricades stay where they are. And they just walk up and down. Franklin Police Volunteer will be adults. The explorers are youth. They're usually from 14 up to 19 years of age. Again, they are strictly volunteer, and they are there from the time the event starts till almost the event is over, volunteering their time to make sure that we have enough security and enough people there for the people.
Thank you, Officer Stigall. So as you can see, it takes a lot of people to get involved, not only from the police department, but many departments throughout the city, in order to make these events the success that they are. Back to you, Melissa.
When the City Insider returns, we'll take you to a once-in-a-lifetime event in downtown Franklin. Did you know that 78 women are forcefully raped every hour in the United States? Just as startling, one out of every four college women reported being sexually assaulted sometime during their 4 years of school. Hello, I'm Rose Stigall, Community Relations Officer for the Franklin Police Department. We are proud to offer a free basic self-defense program for women who live or work in Williamson County. Our 12-hour RAD, or Rape Aggression Defense Program, is designed for the average woman with no previous experience or background in physical skills training. Mothers and daughters are encouraged to attend this free training together. Register now for the next RAD class at the Franklin Police Department. For more information, call 550-6811 or visit us online at www.franklintn.gov and enter the keyword RAD into the search box. Franklin Police Department, professional, progressive, responsive. In October 2009, the Mayor's Battlefield Task Force, the city, and the community all pulled together to rebury the remains of an unknown soldier found at a Franklin construction site. Thousands of people came from across the country to take part in that ceremony and watch the funeral procession and the burying of the unknown soldier at the historic West Haven Cemetery.
This is part of living history. It's a once-in-a-lifetime event to honor and bury an actual Civil War soldier.
The reenactors come from many different places around the country. This is a very, very special event for them.
It's a really big deal, because something like this, I mean, it might come around once in a lifetime to actually get to participate in something like this.
Well, historic tourism is a unique opportunity for the city of Franklin because we have a very rich history, and that really attracts people. Franklin has a great story to tell, and it's a timeless story, and that's powerful. And that brings people here to spend time and money in our community, which is a good thing. And we welcome those visitors and think that's another part of what makes Franklin special. And so this is an opportunity to bring a special focus on that history. We have people from over 27 states that are visiting us, is the latest report. And you know, garnered national media attention.
The Battlefield Task Force worked very hard to pull this together, and it started as a little tiny thought and grew into what it is today. And it takes not just their them to do that, but all the city staff, police and fire and solid waste are all involved. And anytime we do a major event like this, whether it's this or Wind Down Main Street or Street Fest or Pumpkin Fest or Dickens of a Christmas, all the city staff's involved. They work diligently to pull it off. They're really behind the scenes. You don't see them out here, but they're working, they're making sure everybody's safe, and they're making sure at the end of the day the city gets back to the way it was before it started. The community spirit has been wonderful. People have really kind of put their arms around this event and embraced this soldier. And I think for the rest of history that the unknown soldier in the Battle of Franklin will be an important piece of our history.
That really was a remarkable event for our city. Now, Monique McCullough is talking with two different departments to talk about how they go above and beyond during the events in our city.
Thanks, Melissa. Right now, I'm here with Nate Ridley from our Solid Waste Department and Buddy Carter from our Streets Department. Both of these departments are very instrumental in our special events that we have here in the city. Nate, you guys are very visible during our special events. Could you tell me what your primary responsibilities are?
Usually what we do, we want to keep the city pretty clean. We want to dump our canisters and just keep the garbage up and keep it sanitary and healthy for the families down here. And try to make it look pretty all day long. And that way the garbage won't pile up.
Now, we do offer a program. We require that all of our special events have a cleanup plan in place when they have an event in downtown Franklin. And some of them opt to do it themselves, but our Solid Waste Department also has a program, right?
Yes. If you choose to use us for your solid waste services, what we usually do is we'll charge you $150 an hour for at least 2 to 3 guys in one of our smaller trucks to help keep it sanitary and keep the event clean. Usually the minimum hours, they'll get it for about 4 to 5 hours, sometimes 8. It's just one flat rate, $150 an hour, and we'll go from there.
I think it's very worth it because no one cleans up downtown Franklin like our solid waste guys do. Now, there's another program that we've started where we're doing offering recycling for our special events.
Yes, we have recycle bins that we set up now. We set them up beside the cans. We want to keep them uncontaminated. That's the hardest part of it, is keeping the recycle from being contaminated. The best event that we had when we did that, I think it was the Franklin Classic. They did the best job of recycling, and all we had to do was pick the bags up and take them to Clean Earth, have them weighed in, and then have to sort them or anything like that. Usually when they get contaminated, we have to throw the bags away, so it's like really defeating the purpose. But if they can keep them from being contaminated, it helps out a lot.
It ties well into our sustainability efforts.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, Buddy, could you tell me what the Streets Department does both before and after special events?
Before special events, of course, we coordinate everything with you guys down in administration and police and fire, and we do street closures. That takes a lot of time, a lot of coordination with other departments. After the special events, of course, we clean up. We wash the streets down, pick up all the trash that's thrown, and with the help of solid waste, we get that out of the way. But we'll also pressure wash, you know, the food vendor areas, and then open the streets afterwards.
Now, how do you decide what size crew to bring down?
It depends on, if it's a one-day event, of course, we'll have fewer people, but something like the Main Street Festival, we bring a huge crew in because depends on the number of food vendors we have, because if there are a lot of food vendors, there's a lot of street washing, and that's how we do that.
And another event that you're very instrumental in is our tree lighting. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
About a month before, we start going through miles and miles of lights, you know, replacing bulbs, rewiring stuff, and this will be the first year where we don't have a real tree. We're having an artificial tree this year, but in years past, of course, we've had to locate a tree, cut one down, and get it up, but it's just a matter of making sure everything works when the mayor flips a switch, so...
Well, I think you make it sound a lot simpler than it is. You guys do a great job. And I've been down here, of course, during events, and I've seen the fabulous job both of the departments do, and I just want to thank you both for the great jobs that you do. When we come back, Melissa will talk with Nancy Williams. She's Executive Director of the Downtown Franklin Association and coordinator for many of the special events here in Downtown Franklin.
Don't be a water hog.
Don't overwater. You could lose thousands of gallons a day.
Don't be a hog.
Don't use a leaky hose. You could lose 20 gallons a day per leak.
Don't be a water hog.
Don't water your yard at the hardest part of the day.
Don't be a water hog.
Don't wash small loads of laundry or dishes.
Be a water hero. Do reduce outdoor watering and use drought-tolerant landscaping.
Be a water hero. Fix your leaky hose.
Be a water hero.
Take shorter showers.
Be a water hero.
Wash only full loads of laundry and dishes.
Be a water hero.
This message brought to you from the Franklin Water Management Department's campaign, Don't Be a Water Hog, Be a Water Hero. Save water one drop at a time. We're in downtown Franklin, and here with me now is the director of the Downtown Franklin Association, Nancy Williams, and she's going to talk about the many festivals that her group sponsors every year. What are those festivals, Nancy?
Well, we almost have an event every month in downtown Franklin now, but some of the bigger ones are the Franklin Main Street Festival, which is always the last full weekend in April. And we have Pumpkin Fest on Saturday before Halloween, and Dickens of a Christmas, which is always the second full weekend in December. And a newer event is Fela Franklin, right before St. Patrick's Day.
About how many people do these events draw to our city?
Well, the Main Street Festival in April is our largest, and with good weather, it will attract about 130,000 people over 2 days. Pumpkin Fest and Dickens will also attract about 50,000 people. And Fela is a smaller ticketed event, so that'll be about 1,500.
Many of these are annual traditions that have been going on for years. Tell us a little bit how many years each event has been going on.
Well, the Main Street Festival will turn 27 next year in 2010, and it started with the downtown revitalization effort as a way to promote downtown Franklin and bring people from other areas here. And then Pumpkin Fest and Dickens really aren't far behind, both about 25 years old now.
That's amazing. Now, a lot of people come out and have fun at these events, but they don't think about all the work that goes on behind the scenes. You work with the city quite frequently. Tell us about that process and how it works and how it all comes together so people can have fun.
Well, of course, we're a nonprofit association, the Downtown Franklin Association, but we really work closely with the city and depend on the city as a co-sponsor of these events to make it all happen, and it involves several city departments, including, of course, the Franklin Police Department, the Street Department, the Solid Waste Department, the Water Department, and even the Parks Department. They all get involved to make these events run smoothly and to have our town looking great when all the visitors arrive.
And there really is an economic element that when you bring all the people that the merchants downtown really benefit from. Tell us about how they feel about all of these events that happen.
Well, it is always our goal that all the events benefit the downtown merchants because, of course, that's our mission. And, of course, the city of Franklin depends very heavily on sales tax revenue, so we love to bring thousands of visitors in and encourage them to explore shops and restaurants, and there is tremendous economic benefit from that, and especially at Dickens of a Christmas, because that's a time where we get to showcase the beautiful architecture of our town, and also, I mean, more than 70 unique shops and restaurants that are just in these few blocks of the downtown area, and, you know, comes right there in the middle of December, so that's a nice little economic boom there at the end of the year.
Well, Nancy, thanks for joining us. Good information. And right now we're going to take you to Pumpkin Fest. We're here at Pumpkin Fest, one of the most fun events here in the city of Franklin. Take a look at this giant pumpkin. It came all the way from Canada, Carleton Place, Canada, which is one of our sister cities. Right now I'm going to talk with Norm O'Neill and Wayne Morris. Norm is from Building and Neighborhood Services, and Wayne is from Franklin Fire. And they come out and make sure that these events are safe for our city. Norm, what do you do at these events?
I do the electrical inspections to try to make sure that all the cords are down, no trip hazards, all the devices are plugged in and safe.
I know yesterday you were out at the carnival and kind of inspecting that. Tell us what you did yesterday.
Well, same thing. We inspect the carnival to make sure that the rides are covered, the cords feeding to those are covered up, and try to make everything safe for the people to walk and visit and to the carnival.
So pretty much any event that happens in the city of Franklin, are you here making sure that everything's safe for the citizens?
There's someone from our department. There's several inspectors that works in our department, and there's always somebody that comes out if there's electrical that needs to be used at the event.
Okay, thanks, Norm.
Wayne is with Franklin Fire, and you guys come out and inspect. What do you do here?
Well, the multiple things, as Norm has mentioned. We look at the tents that are erected up for the events, mainly with them when they're doing cooking. We look for fire extinguishers in the tents, make sure that the tents meet the flammability specifications for NFPA. And we also make sure that the cooking areas have the proper distances from anything else that could catch on fire. Some of the other things we do is deal with the alleyways. Whenever there's an event down here on Main Street is basically closed. We have no access to the front of the building, so we make sure all the alleyways are clear, that all the vendors have moved all their vehicles and everything out of the way, that we can get a fire apparatus down here, or a rescue ambulance and things like that down here to provide emergency services to everybody.
So you're not here not only before the event, but during the event as well.
That's correct. We start early before the event as the setup occurs, and then maintain presence down here during the event. And then we also have bicycle medics with Williamson County and for Franklin Fire is always here during the entire event. And then in some cases we're here after the event as it shuts down, so the streets we make sure they're open properly and that we have our access to the main street.
All right, thanks guys so much for being here. They are keeping the events here in Franklin safe for all citizens so they can just have fun when they're here. Right now we're going to show you some sights and sounds of Pumpkin Fest, and then Anna will show you some information about events in our city parks. Melissa, I'm Anna Shuford. I'm the program coordinator for the City of Franklin Parks Department, and we're here at the annual Family Day at the park at Harlansdale Farm. And with me is Parks Director Lisa Clayton. Lisa, what a great day. We couldn't have asked for a better day.
Oh, it's a fabulous day, Anna, in November, and the people are coming out in groves.
Oh, we've got so many things to do here today. Lisa, how would one go about having an event sort of like we've planned here today at one of our parks?
Sure, Anna. All you have to do is visit our website or call us at the Parks Department. We have a special event permit. It takes you step by step through the program, and therefore you could have an event just like we have out here.
And Lisa, are there other venues rather than here that one could event, say a Christmas party or graduation parties?
Oh, most definitely, especially for the winter months, the Eastern Flank Battlefield Park. The facility out there is for rental. It's got wonderful area for space or tents, anything. So it's a great place.
Wonderful. And Lisa, we haven't had this event. We missed last year because we were under construction, so we hadn't had this event last year. But we wanted to get people out here and let them see the park and what all's going on. What could one do if we weren't out here programming today and you wanted to bring your family out? What would one do out here at the park at Harlansdale?
Well, I tell you, everybody recreates differently. So if you wanted to come out and paint a picture, read a book, we have a 5-acre pond, though. It's a gem on the property. We've stocked it with fish. It's a fish and release program. So you bring out your children and fish on the pond. You also, we are creating walking trails. So you'll be able to come out, walk about a 2-mile length of the farm, but it's just a gorgeous piece of property.
And we do want to remind folks, Lisa, that TWRA says, you got to have a fishing license, right?
Exactly. So that shouldn't stop you. You can gain any license at any of the local stores here in Franklin.
Walmart's got them, the Sports Goods.
Dick's Sporting Goods. So just grab your license, and you can actually just get a 1 to 3 day pass.
Absolutely.
If you'd like.
Yeah, you can. Well, thank you so much, Lisa. I know we've got a lot going on, but I appreciate you stopping for just a few minutes, taking the time to speak to us today here at the park at Harlansdale Farm.
Now we're going to take you to one of the biggest events in Franklin, the Veterans Day Parade. Monique McCullough is there.
Hi, we're here today at the Franklin Veterans Day Parade. This parade is a joint effort between local radio station WAKM AM 950 and the City of Franklin. With me right now is Linda Carden, sales manager for WAKM. Thanks for joining us, Linda.
Oh, Monique, it's my pleasure. You know, we have a beautiful day, absolutely perfect weather. We've got marching bands, school children, bells ringing, a lot of chaos, but so much fun.
It certainly is. Now, how long has this parade been going on?
You know, we reinstituted the parade after 9/11 in 2001, so this is the ninth parade, and it is absolutely bigger than any parade we've ever done. And maybe it's the weather, maybe it's just the continuity, but it's an awesome parade.
That's great. Now, what makes this event so special?
Well, you know, you and I have talked about trying to train our younger children, our up-and-coming generations, of the importance of country and freedom and what it takes to keep our country free. And this parade is a debt of gratitude to the men and women who have served decades, long before we were here, keeping our country free, making sure those freedoms were still available for these kids coming up. So we want them to know the value of country and patriotism, and thank you to the men and women who serve.
Absolutely. Now, what does the City of Franklin do to help in this endeavor?
Well, you know, you and I work very closely coordinating this event. It's not easy, but it's fun. We have to contact schools, we have to contact bands, we have to contact marching units. And today, Monique, one of our honored prize guests, absolutely sweetest lady, Miss Jane Covington, who was one of the first women in the United States Navy in World War II. Delightful lady, and she's leading the parade up there somewhere, and she's just so excited to be here.
And Williamson County resident, right?
Yes, she is. So we're very honored to have her here, as well as all of these men and women who've served. Some still have on their uniforms from times past, so it's fun to watch, and they really appreciate it.
This is absolutely one of my favorite events that we do, so let's go enjoy this parade. Thank you, Linda.
Enjoyed this edition of the City Insider, and that you learned a little bit about the events that happen in downtown Franklin. We'll see you next time on the City Insider.